الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء من شيء ربنا بعد. ونستعين استعانة راض بفضله، واثق بدفعه، مؤمل لنفعه، ونستغفره ونسترشده ونستهديه، ونؤمن به ونتوب إليه ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة وفتح به أعينا عميا وآذانا صما وقلوبا غلفا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وعلى من اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، فهذا عباد الله، هذا اليوم هو يوم عرفة. The day of Arafah. And the scholars, some of them said this is the أفضل أيام السنة. And some they said the best day of the year is the day, next day, which is tomorrow, يوم النحر الأكبر. But يوم عرفة is a very special day because it has so many things, significant things. First of all, عرفة يتميز بفضل الزمان وفضل المكان. المكان, the place, is عرفة. What's the significance of Arafah? This is the place, that's the only place that you can perform Hajj. You cannot perform Hajj except that you have to be in that place, in that time. The day of Arafah, this, if you miss the day of Arafah, if you miss to go there and you're going for Hajj, you miss the Hajj. As Rasulullah SAW said, Al-Hajj Arafah. So this is the significance of the place. Why it was called Arafah? There's so many ruayat. One of them is that Rasulullah ﷺ said, this is Yawm Al-Ahd, the day of the covenant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took from Adam, from his loin, from his back, all the dhurriya. And this is mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf. وَاتْأَخَذَ اللَّهُ أَلَسْتُ بَرَبِّكُمْ وَاتْأَخَذَ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ. قال أَلَسْتُ بَرَبِّكُمْ. He took from the Adam all the, what do you call now these days, maybe DNA or something, and he brought all the people that they coming from Adam until the day of judgment. They are like you know, DNA. And Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Surah Al-A'raf, He said, أَلَسْتُ بَرَبِّكُمْ أَلَسْتُ بَرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَا شَهِدْنَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He took from every human being this oath. And that was in Al-Nu'man, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said, which is a place, Al-Nu'man is the same name of Arafah. So in that place, in Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took from Adam, from his loin, the whoever coming from Adam, from his descendant until the day of judgment, and he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talked to them and told them, Alastu Rabbikum, am I your Lord? Testifies, he said, yes, shahidna. So every human being actually, he has in his own self, he gave covenant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, kafir or not kafir, Christian, Jewish, Hindu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took from every human being this covenant. And he said in the Surah Al-A'raf, to the day of judgment, do not come and say, I didn't know about it. Because he took from them. So actually, every human being, even if he say, I don't believe in God, if he has a problem, he say God. Right away, he look at the, you know, at the sky. Because this is what the day, the place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took from Adam, from his zurriya, from his offspring, this covenant, it was in Arafah. This is one explanation. The second thing, another explanation, that Arafah is Arafah because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the al-arwah, the souls of all human beings, and al-arwah التي al-arwah al-mu'mineen ta'arafat, ta'alafat. And this is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, al-arwah ta'arafat means they know each other. The soul of the believers, they know each other. And this is the place of Arafah. The third explanation of Arafah, it is in Ruwayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Adam alayhi salam and Hawa, they descended from the heaven, the Ruwayat said that Adam alayhi salam went to India and Hawa in Jeddah. And then they met in Arafah. And this is what they know each other. Like they know each other before, but تعرفوا في عرفة في that place. So this is different explanation. Now the عرفة itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it that the time of عرفة for the forgiveness. And as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said, ما من يوم يعتق الله فيه عبادا أكثر من يوم عرفة. This is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free so many people from the hellfire in this day of Arafah. Not only the people there, but everywhere. This is what that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So this is the day of Arafah. Yawm al-Maghfirah. Yawm al-Ahd. That's the Ahd that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the covenant from the people. And then Yawm أفضل الدعاء, the best دعاء of the year is the دعاء of يوم عرفة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said أفضل الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. And he said, what is the دعاء of يوم عرفة? He said, أفضل ما قلت أنا والنبيين من قبلي لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. This is a dua. It is a praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah. No one has the right to be worshipped but Allah. Wahdahu la sharika lah. He has no partner. Lahul mulk. His is the dominion. His is lahul hamd. The praise. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. And he is able to do all things. This is a dua. Somebody said, this is not dua. This is just praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best dua of the year and the best dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that because you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of all your needs after that. So this is the best dua in the day of Arafah. And this dua you should repeat as much as possible. The same thing, Arafah is one of the days of Ashur al-Hurum, which is Ashur al-Hurum, means Ashur al-Hurum, Zul Qa'dah, Zul Hijjah, and Muharram, and Rajab. Three in a row, and one by itself. This Ashur al-Hurum. And Arafah is in these months. And also, Arafah is one day of the Ashur الحج. What's the أشهر الحج؟ شوال and ذو القعدة and ذو الحجة. This أشهر الحج. And then also Allah سبحانه وتعالى swear by the 10 days of ذو الحجة خطبة last week. And day of Arafah is one of those 10 days. والفجر وليال عشر. Allah سبحانه وتعالى give oath by these 10 days. And also Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah Al-Buruj, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى give oath and swear by, He said, والسماء ذات البروج. This is one. The heaven with all the stars. واليوم الموعود. The promised day. And the most of the scholars said the promised day is the day of judgment. وشاهد ومشهود. Witnessing and witnessed day. Witnessing, the scholar said, also with some opinion, but the scholar said, witnessing day is the day of Jum'ah, Friday. And the witnessed day is the day of Arafah. Witnessing Friday. And today, actually, both. This is, you know, amazing. This is the best thing when Friday comes and Arafah comes in the same day. So the washahidin wa mashhud, the witnessing day and the witness day. And why is witness day? Because the angel witnessed this day. And this is yawm al-mubaha, means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draw near to earth. And then he shows the angels. He actually, mubaha means that you brag or you say, this is, you be proud of those people in Arafah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the angel, look at my servant, look at my servant. And then he said, why they came? Just a question like that. And of course, I mean, when he is proud of them, it means that he will forgive them. So this is the day of Mubaha, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is proud of his slaves, and proud of his slaves in front of the angels. Then also this is the day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا رُؤْيَ الشَّيْطَانِ أَحْقَرْ وَلَا أَذَلْ وَلَا أَضْحَرْ مِنْ هَذَا الْيَوْمِ لِمَا يَرَى فِيهِ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ تَتَنَزَّلِ. The shaitan in this day, that day of Arafah, he is the most repelled, humiliated, insignificant, angry. All these things that describe the shaitan in this day. Why? Because he sees the rahmat, the mercy descending on the believers. And this is the shaitan, his work for some people, that he worked for them all their life. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever attended the Hajj, as Rasulullah sallam said, man hajja falam yarfus walam yafsuq raja'a ka yawm waladathu ummu wal hajj al mabrur laysa lahu jaza'un illa al jannah. That if you perform the Hajj the right way, you don't make jidal, you don't make all those kind of sins, ليس له جزاء. There is no reward except paradise. And he said, ومن حج فلم يرفث ولم يفسق, he come back as if he's newborn. So the shaitan see he worked for that person for so many years, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy comes and erase all those sins, remove everything. So all his workers, millions of hours of working on people to mislead them and to make them commit sins and all kind of sin, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase everything. So this is the day of Arafah. The day of Arafah is a day that also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, you make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you are not in Arafah, but you fast this day of Arafah, if you fast, inshallah all of us are fasting. Yeah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أحتسب أنه يغفر أو ذنوب العام الماضي والعام المقبل. He will erase the sins of Last year and the year to come. This is the day of Arafah. So, Alhamdulillah, we are attending and having this day, and you should make lots of dua. Takbir also. Takbir is there's two kinds of takbir. Takbir mutlaq or takbir muqayyad. Takbir mutlaq means that you make takbir from starting first day of Dhul Hijjah until the Asr of the 13 of Dhul Hijjah, end of Asr. So this is called takbir mutlaq, mean that you can make takbir while driving, you can make takbir sitting. And there is takbir muqayyad, mean that there is only after prayers. When start this? Started this morning, after Fajr. After Fajr, you make takbir after every salah. From Fajr today until the 13 of Dhul Hijjah after Asr. So these are the days of takbir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this Hajj as the seal of this religion. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is only performed one Hajj. As Jabir ibn Abdullah said, Makkah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 9 sanawat. 9 years he stayed in Medina. لم يحج وفي اليوم وفي السنة العاشرة أذن أن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم حاج هذا العام. So they announced the Rasul coming هذا العام for Hajj. So actually all the Sahaba came from everywhere. How many were accompanying Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in this Hajj? They call it Hajj al-Wada, but it's only one Hajj. The scholar said 130,000. As Jabir ibn Abdullah said, فَخَرَجْنَا إِلَى ذُو الْحُلَيْفَةِ. This is the miqat where you make the ihram there. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the ihram at ذُو الْحُلَيْفَةِ and وَصَلَّى بِالْمَسْجِدِ. He prayed there, the masjid there. And then he rode his camel, al-Qiswa. جابر عبد الله سيد فنظرت على أمام بين يدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فمد البصر ناس people you can't even see the end ونظرت على يمينه مد البصر وعلى شماله مد البصر ومن خلفه مد البصر كلهم جاءوا all of them came to Medina not only from Medina came to Medina so they be with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم while he's performing the Hajj. So this is the day of Arafah, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I mentioned last week, completed this deen, perfected this deen. And in the day of Arafah, which was also on Friday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. So this is the day of perfection of this deen. Most of the ahkam was revealed. Maybe few ahkam came after that, but most of the ahkam was revealed of the deen. And the last thing is the hajj, how to perform hajj. So when the sahaba went to Medina to accompany Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was بين أظهرنا والقرآن يتنزل عليه وهو يعلم تأويله. So actually Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with them and he is surrounded by 130,000 sahabi. 130,000 sahabi. And the Quran coming down on him and he knows the tafsir of the Quran and he was performing the Hajj and he said خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَسِكُمْ. So all those people actually copying Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم what he was doing. So he was actually performing the Hajj. And this is a big hadith, long hadith with Jabir ibn Abdullah how Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم performed the Hajj. This is a very famous hadith. So this is what the end or the perfection of this religion as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that day, this day, today I have perfected your religion and completed my favor on you and chosen Islam as your religion. And this is the day of Arafah. So all these are the significance of the day of Arafah. And we are actually required lots of takbir, lots of making dua, la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. We ask some people, they said, why is only praising? Because they said, just imagine, of course there is, you can't make any comparison, but if you go to a rich person and you are a beggar, and instead of saying, give me this, give me that, you said, you are the most generous person from the most noble family, and so on. You praise that person. You don't ask him anything, he gave you. So this is the dua of Arafah, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has no partner, and he is the one only has the right to be worshipped, and he has the dominion, and the only one has the dominion and has the praise, and he is able to do all things. قول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لك واستغفره وانا الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, إن شاء الله tomorrow إن شاء الله the Eid prayer will be 9 o'clock. We are had to twist the arm of Abdul Wahab to make it early a little bit because he want 9:30, but actually it should be early because people going after prayer to go for sacrifice. Okay, so it's better Eid al-Adha, Eid al-Fitr, you should be late, so you can have breakfast because you break your fast after Ramadan, and then you have the Eid prayer later on. But Eid al-Adha should be as early as possible, so you can pray and then you go for sacrifice. فصلي لربك وانحر. You pray first and then you sacrifice. Inshallah, tomorrow we'll continue that how Rasulullah ﷺ, when he started from Medina and followed with all the Sahaba, and he arrived to Mina. After that, on the 8th of the Hijjah, and then on the 9th of the Hijjah, in 8th of the Hijjah, he prayed all prayers from Zuhr until next day Arafah in the Fajr, and then after that he went to Arafah, and then he gives the khutbah, and this khutbah is called khutbah al-Wada', or the farewell khutbah. And this is very important khutbah because this is summarizing the principle of Islam, and actually the talking not only to the Sahaba or even to the generation to come, but even talking to all humanity. This khutbah al-Wada', inshallah, will go through some of the, you know, aspect of this khutbah inshallah, and Eid prayer. عباد الله, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين. اللهم صل على محمد في الآخرين. اللهم صل على محمد في كل وقت وحين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين, وأذل الشرك والمشركين, وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين, واخذل كفرة أعدائك أعداء الدين. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في هذا اليوم ذنبا إلا غفرته, ولا مريضا إلا شفيته, ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته, ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا قضيتها ويسرتها, يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم ضعفنا واجبر كسرنا وتولى أمرنا. اللهم اهد قلوبنا واشرح صدورنا وآمن روعاتنا واختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم, ولذكر الله أكبر, والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.